Good morning, youth ballet dancers. Welcome to our week 3 class video. So we are going to start, like we always do, with our bar warm-up exercises. And you can either use your chair or your shelf or the foot of your bed, whatever you're using for your bar. Or you can do it like me, with your hands on your hips in the center. So I have my pliés first. Feet are in first position. And I make those diamonds for my demi-pliés. 3 times, plié, and stretch, plié, and stretch. 3 times, and tendu the right foot. Press it down in second. Now I make that cupcake shape for my demi-plié in second. 3 times, 2, and stretch, 3, and stretch. Really make sure those knees bend, bend, bend. And then I take that same right foot, tendu, bring it back to first. And I'm gonna go to the other side. So I have my 3 in first, tendu, to second with the left foot, 3 in second, tendu back to first. We're gonna go right into our tendus from here. So first position feet, and my right foot goes forward. Oh, decide what kind of gemstone you have first. So let's see, today I think I have a fire opal. And so we have that on the inside of those heels. We're pressing that gemstone forward the whole way. I have my 1 and back, 2, and back, keeping both knees as straight as can be. 3, and a flex, and a point, and a close. To the side, it's on that diagonal angle. And to the back, that's the trickiest one. I have to keep my hip right over those standing toes so that I don't fall over going to the back, especially if I'm not holding on to something. And then I take it, oh, I don't take it back to the side because I have my 4 relevés. Then I take the left foot, so gemstone forward, 3 times, flex, point, close, to the side, 3 tendus, flex, point, close, to the back, 3 tendus, flex, point, close, and 4 relevés, keeping our weight on those first 2 toes. No pinky toes for the sickled relevés. Ooh, no thank you. Then I am going into my rond de jambe, so our nice slow rond de jambe, circling that leg, circle of the leg, taking that gemstone still forward with my right foot, forward, to the side, to the back, and bring your gemstone through. Straight knees the whole way. Knees never, ever, ever bend in those rond de jambes. And I'm gonna take it 4 times, starting to the front with the right foot, 4 times starting to the back with the right foot, 4 times front left, 4 times back left. All right, find your hands on your hips if you're standing in the center without something to hold on to, or put your hands on your makeshift bar. And we'll get ready to do those pliés. Ready, nice and tall, lifting that belly button. Shoulders are pressed down, spine is long, and we go. Demi, and stretch. Demi, and stretch. Demi, and stretch. And tendu, right foot, press down in second. Demi, and stretch. Demi, and stretch, demi, and stretch, and tendu back to first. Ready again in first, demi, and stretch, lifting that belly button still, and stretch, and 3 times, tendu left foot, and press it down in second, and we go, demi, and stretch, demi, and stretch, and tendu back to first to finish. Let's make sure we've got those gemstones on the inside of those heels and we're ready to do our tendus. Right foot first, straight to the front. And we'll go 7 and 8. Tendu front and close, front and close, front, and a flex, and a point, and close. Side, on that diagonal, side, and close. Both knees are nice and straight. Point, and close to the back. Knees stay straight here too, and headlights going forward. Back, and a flex, and a point, and close. And releve 1. Weight on those first 2 toes, no pinky toes. 3, and down, and four, other side. We go front, close, two, three, with a flex and a point, and close, and to the side, side, close, two, close, three, flex, point, and close, to the back, back, and close, back, and close, back, and a flex, and a point, and close, four releves, up, straight knees, up, and down, three, and a four, and finish nice and tall. Keep lifting that belly button, nice tall posture. We're ready to go right into those round jumps, taking that right foot first to the front four times. Find your front, side, back, and first position. Ready? Seven and eight. We go front, side, back, and first. Front, side, back, and first. Two more times going front, side, back, and first, and front, side, back, and first. Now starting to the back, back, side, front, and first position. Back, keeping both knees straight, side, front, and first position, knees still straight. Back, and side, and front, and first. This is the last one on the right foot. Side, front, and first. Other leg, left to the front. And side, and back, and first. Find your balance on that standing leg. Hip goes right over those standing toes. And first. Front, and side, and back, and first. Keeping that gemstone forward. That gemstone still forward, and the gemstone still forward with my hips forward. And to the back. Back, and side, and front, and first, back, and side, and front, and first. Two more. Back, see your gemstone, side, front, and first. Last time, see those gemstones, headlights to the front, side, front, and first. And finish nice and tall, lifting your belly button. Shoulders are down, spine is long, feet are turned out, booties are squeezed. Okay, we are gonna go across the floor taking our retiré walks. So we know those retirés where I point that foot in front of me to step on my foot and my other foot goes pointed to my knee and my knee is facing straight forward. Now this foot has to go out in front of me, point to the ground, to step on it, it points where I'm heading. And then my other foot points that toe right at my knee and my knee is pointing straight forward. We're gonna take it across the floor on our diagonal lines. If that's gonna give you more space in the space that you're dancing in, more room to go across the floor, or you can just go side to side. Whatever gives you the most length to do this exercise across the floor. I'm going on my diagonal lines and I'm gonna go step, point that toe, and then up to my retiré. Step, point that toe, and up to my retiré. Step, point that toe, and up to my retiré. All the way across, and then I'll go from the other side. Actually, I'm gonna start from this corner over here so that I'm starting with the right foot. But we're going all the way across one direction, and then we'll bring it to the top of the other corner or the other side and get ready to go across the other direction, starting with the left foot. Starting with that right foot in front, point that right toe. We go retiré, and step point, retiré, step point, retiré, step point, retiré, until you run out of room. Good. I'm going to come from my other corner this time, starting with my left foot. I go step point, right to right, 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 until I run out of my room. Good. I'm going to try it one more time, starting with that right foot. Point, step right to right, 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 until I run out of room. Other side, one more time, starting with the left foot. Step point, right to right, 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 until I'm all out of room. Okay, we are gonna do this one more time, going from each corner, but this time we're changing it up. So we started working on our turned out passe retiré last week, where we take that crayon on our toe, whatever color you want. I think mine's gonna be my favorite color today, so mine's gonna be green. So I'm gonna draw that green line from my toe all the way up the front of my leg to my knee. So I go all the way up, 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 up to my knee. And my other knee, the one I'm pulling up, is facing to the side instead of to the front. So instead of a parallel retiré, I have a turned out retiré. So we're using our turned out positions. Now I'm gonna practice taking my turned out retirés across the floor. I'm gonna start from my right side, but for now you can see me a little bit better at this angle. So I'll show my turned out. I also have to turn out the foot that I'm standing on, so I wanna turn it out as I step onto it. So my standing foot is also turned out. And I go retiré, toe to the side, and no, sickle at the knee, point the foot, and that inside ankle bone is pushing forward, that heel gemstone is pushing forward. So I go, point, step on it, retiré, knee to the side, point, step on it, retiré, knee to the side, point, step on it, retiré, knee to the side, all the way down, and then from my other corner as well. But like I said, I'm gonna start on my right side. Okay, are you ready to do it? Starting with that right foot, and we'll go. Point, step, retiré, point, step, retiré, turn it out. This one's a little trickier, but you can do it. Until we run out of room. And let's go from the other corner, starting with the left foot this time. Point, step, retiré, 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 until I'm out of room. I'm gonna try it one more time on each side. Right foot, point it out to the front, and we're ready to turn it out. Point, step, retiré, point, step, retiré, and up, and up, and from my other corner. Ready with that left foot, ready to go out in front. Point, step, retiré, point, retiré, and up, turning that knee out far to the side. Good job, dancers, that was great. All right, dancers, we are gonna stretch in the center. So let's have a seat, and let's make those butterflies, so bottoms of the feet together. Don't pull up on your toes, but you can push them together, you can press them down, or you can grab onto those ankles, which is what I'm gonna do. Let's give it a little rock to the side to side so you can feel both those sits bones underneath you on one side and the other. Good. Okay, find yourself centered in between both those sits bones. And we are going to stretch over to the side. So take one hand up and over. And get that good stretch through the side, but not picking up that sits bone. And other way, keeping both sits bones down, stretching up and over. Good, all right, grab those ankles, and I'm pressing my belly button forward so that I have my nice straight spine, right? Not curving, curving, curving to get my nose to my toes, but pressing my belly button forward and my tailbone back so that I can try and get my nose to my toes that direction. Ready, we're gonna hold it for 20 counts. Belly button forward, tailbone back, And we'll hold 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, let's sit back up. We'll grab onto those ankles, point our toes, press them all the way forward to our pike stretch until those legs are nice and straight. From here, we're going to take a little stretch up and over to the side and to the other direction. Still feeling both sits bones on the floor. We'll walk our hands all the way up to those toes, keeping them very, very, very pointed. And we'll hold for 20 counts. 20, 19, still bringing that belly button forward. 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, dancers, we're going to open up to our straddle stretch, and we're going to reach it side to side, up and over those toes, and not letting those sits bones pick up off the floor like this, keeping them pressed down. So as I stretch to this side, this sits bone might want to come up, but I'm not going to let it. Keep it locked to the floor. Good, stretching side to side. Now I'm going to take that right hand right in front of me. My left hand is going to come up and over to the right side. And I want to make sure that my tailbone isn't pressing forward, isn't pushing forward, pointing forward. It's pressing back so that I'm leaning shoulders in front of my hips. And I'll come all the way up. I'm going to go reach side to side again. And now that left hand comes in front of me so I can take my right hand up and over. And my shoulders should still be in front of my hips, not behind. Up and over. Don't let that sits bone come off. Good. And bring it all the way up. We're going to even reach it forward a little bit. You can reach your hands forward in front of you, so you want your shoulders in front of those hips. If it's more comfortable, you can put your elbows on the ground here, or you can even reach even further forward. Good, we'll sit all the way up, and we're gonna do our half lunge, half split stretch. So we make those two boxes, or our box and our half box, right? My knee is right over that heel, and I'm gonna push that foot forward a few inches, get that knee right on top of the heel again. My hands go down to the ground. So if my knee is way far in front of my heel, that's not correct. I won't get a good stretch there, I won't get a safe stretch there. And if my knee is behind my heel, I won't get any kind of stretch at all here. So keep that knee right over your heel. And my other knee should be behind my hip. So if it's right underneath, I'm not getting a stretch. Has to stay behind that hip. I should feel stretch here and a little bit under here as well. And we're gonna push into that muscle and then press our hips back. Keep that front leg nice and straight and hands on the ground. Hips stay high. So again, if I sat down on my back leg, that's not correct either. I have to keep my foot in the front right where it was and my leg in the back right where it was and just straighten out that front knee. Hips stay high. Let's try it 8 times. So I'll go front and hips back. Hips front, hips back. 3 and back and 4. And back, 5, and back, 6, and back, 7, and back, and here's our last one on this side, 8, and back. Let's try the other side. So I make my two boxes. I've got my one box right here and my half box back here. Shift that heel forward a few inches. And keep the knee right on top of the heel.
This back knee is behind my hip. As I go forward, hands are on the ground. And then I push my hips back, straighten out my knee, and my hips stay nice and high. My feet don't move anywhere at all when I make that change. And I'll go 8 times. Front and back. And 2. And 3. And back. 4. And back. 5. And back. 6. And back. 7. And back. And 8. And back. Good job, dancers. Okay, we are going to take a couple of exercises in the center and then practice our recital dance for ballet. Okay, dancers, our first exercise here in the center is going to be our passe retirés. So I'm getting all the way up to that turned out retiré position, and I'm passing my foot up the front of my leg to get it there. So we did this earlier with our retiré walks, right? With my turned out leg. Now I've got to take that drawn line up the front of my leg to my knee. So I'm going to put that crayon on my toe. I think I'm going to use pink this time. So I'm going to draw that pink line up the front of my leg to my knee. And I go, point that toe, get your crayon ready to draw. Up, 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 knees going to the side only. Pointed toe to that standing knee. And then draw it right back down. And I'll go to the other side. Shift your weight. Hip over those standing toes. Take that toe, ready to draw your line, whatever color you've got. Up, 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 knee to the side. All the way to that standing knee. And back down. Let's do it a few more times. We'll go up, 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 up. And down, down, down. Back to first in between. And shift your weight for the other side. Up, 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 up. Down, down, down. Up, 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 and down, down, down. This will be our last one. I shift, point that toe, draw your line, up, up, up. Knees going as far to the side as I can, and down, 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 back to my first. Now we're going to take that passe retiré in a little combination, so a little combination of moves. I'm going to start with my chaîne turn. So we're starting to get pretty used to this chaîne turn, right? My chaîne turn, my chain links together. So I go my open, and a close, and a open, and a close, and a open. If I'm headed to the left side, I'm going to take something from my right hand and pass it into that left hand because that's where I'm headed. And I have to pass it in front or behind me. In front should be our answer, right? If I'm passing behind me, I'll get my pancake flip, right? Because my arms can't close in front if I go behind me. So I want to make sure that I'm closing that circle in front as I turn. No pancake flips. My foot and my hand both go in front. So pass something from the right to the left hand. Cross in front. Turn and open. And get ready to point back the other way. So now I have something in my left hand and I'm going to pass it to the right. As I step on that pointed foot, cross both front arm and front leg. Close and open to point back the other direction. So we're going to take the chaîne turn and the passe retiré together in a combination. So I'm going to go point that toe, I close, I open, and I'm going to, instead of coming right back into my other chaîne, I'm going to close in first position and bring my hands to my hips to go up, 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 down, 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 and then the other side, up, 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 down, 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 down. Now I'll go back. So I point that toe. I go open, pass it in front, close, open. I've got that pointed toe, and I'll bring it into my first with my hands on my hips. I go up, 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 down, 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 up, 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 down, 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 down. Just like that. Let's try that a couple of times. So I go, point your toe, open, and close. Open, and up, 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 down, 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 up, 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 down, down, down. Other side, open and close, open and close in first position, up, 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 down, 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 up, up, up,
down, down, down. Let's try it one more time on each side. Open, close, open, point, close in first. Up, 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 down, 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 up, 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 down, down, down. Other side. Open, close, open, and close in first. Up, 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 down, 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 up, 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 down, down, down. All right, dancers, we are going to practice our recital dance. Now, we know the beginning part where we start in our V, and I'm gonna be doing it how I did in last week's video, with our V facing the back, so that it's like you're looking at my back facing the mirror, yes? Okay, so we have our V, right? We know this part. We have our group ones on stage right, our group twos on stage left. Our arms come up for four counts, up for four counts, open for four counts, circle for four counts. And then we have our tendus, tendus, and our balancés, balancés, tendus, tendus, balancés, and balancés. Here's where we split into our group A and group B. My A's go down on their knee. That right knee facing stage right. And my B's put their hands on their hips, foray for four counts towards their partner. You have four counts to get to the side of your partner, and then four counts for your arabesque on their shoulder. That left leg going up and then coming back in. As that leg comes back in, our other partner, our kneeling partner, stands up. Now this is what we added last time. Ballet run, so arms in first position and on those tiptoes. Ballet run, one, two, three, four. Just coming forward for now. We won't worry about spots just yet. But one, two, three, four to get forward, and we have our arms open. Five, six, seven, eight. Shall I turn to the right? Shall I turn to the left? Shall I turn right? Open. Pass in front, close. Open, and point that toe, and then back to the left. Open, close in front. Open, point that toe. That's as far as we got last time. We are going to add one more part this week. We are doing some bourrées after this. So after we finished our chaîne turn, we're going to take our hands to our hips and bourré. We're actually doing our bourrées backwards, but that's okay. It's not going to be too much harder than our regular bourrées forwards, right? I just take them going bourré forward, front foot, back foot, front foot, back foot. I'm doing it backwards, I just go back, front, back, front, back, front. It's not much harder at all. So we're taking our bourrées backwards and to either side. So I will let us know who's going which direction. So we all came forward into our spots for our opening those arms. Chaîne to the right, chaîne to the left. Miss Leah, Madeline, Avery, and Annie will be heading this direction towards the left side of the room. So you'll be bourreing to your left backwards. Now, my other dancers, Vivian, Maeve, Alexandra, and Maya will be going this direction. If you notice, it's the same side of the stage you were on in our V. So in my V formation, I had Leah, Madeline, Avery, and Annie on the left side. And I had Vivian, Maeve, Alexandra, and Maya on the right side. So, we're going to whatever side you were in for our V. Yeah? My group ones for that first arm section, going to the right. My group twos for that first arm section, going to the left. Yes? All right. We are going to try adding that into the dance. I'm going to do the bourré part. So if you are a kneeler, if you're one of my A partners who kneels, know that you go down in that kneel, okay? And I will be doing the bourré part. So four to your partner, grab the hand, four around, and four to arabesque, and come back down, okay? Then we have our run forward, open, chaînes, and our bourrées to either sides.
Group one. Group two. To hips, time to do right and side, left and side, balance a right and balance a left. Keep those headlights forward, left foot. And my A's kneel as my B's foray to their partner for four counts. Foray around the back for four counts. Arabesque. And leg comes down. My other partner stands up. Ballet run to the front. One, two, three, four. Open. Six, seven, eight. Point that toe. Close. Point that toe. Close. Point that toe. And we either go right to the left or the right. So dancers, don't forget, you can go back in this video, you can rewind and replay that section of our video as many times as you need to practice that recital dance until you are super, super comfortable with it. All right, dancers, if you need to, pause the video now and put your tap shoes on and get your floor ready to practice tap. So if you need to put a piece of cardboard down or a piece of wood down so you don't scratch up your floors, get it ready for our tap section. Ready to warm up. Take that right foot out in front of you. Little five, six, seven, eight, and tap. Take it to our heels. Drop the right heel. Left. Right. Left. Double time. And let's double that time again. Ready? Faster. So every time we double time, we're getting faster. Let's double it again. Good job. We're going to take our 8 shuffles with the right foot. We'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Other foot, we go 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. No heels allowed, just those toes. 6, 7, 8. And we're going to take our shuffle while change, starting with the right foot. 4 times on the right, and then 4 times on the left. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. Shuffle, ball, change. Shuffle, ball, change. Last time. Other foot. 5, 6, 7, 8. Shuffle, ball, change. 2, 3, and 4. Good job. We're going to take our paradiddle. So starting with that right foot. Dig, spank, toe, and heel.
dig, spank, toe, and heel. We're gonna do 8 just to start. Going right foot to left foot. Ready? 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 more. 5, 6, 7, and 8. Good. We're gonna take our stomp, stomp. Spank back, spank back. So this is the tricky one where we land on those tippy toes. Starting with that right foot, you guys. Stomp, spank back, spank back. Stomp, spank back, spank back. I'm gonna do it to the side so you can really see. I go stomp, stomp, and then like I'm scraping the bubblegum off that toe. Spank, just the toe, and land on the tippy toe. 7, 8. Stomp, stomp, spank back, spank back. Last one. Good. Give it a little shake out. Nice warm up. All right, dancers, we are learning a new move this week. This is our buffalo. Now, we started a while back, we started some prep for our buffaloes, stepping on one foot. So I'm going to step on my left foot and shuffle my right foot. But this time, instead of shuffling forward, I'm going to take that shuffle to the side. So kind of on that first position diagonal when I'm doing my tendus to the sides, right? So I'm taking it on that diagonal angle going to the side. So I'm going to step on that left foot. Step, shuffle the right foot. Shuffle. Now this foot is up in the air. I want to hop to it. Hop. And as I hop, I'm going to cross my foot I originally stepped on, my left foot, I'm going to cross it in front so it makes like a little number 4. So I'm going to go jump to that foot, shuffle, and now hop to that back foot, cross in front, make your 4. So it's not quite like my retiro or my passe where I put my toe to my knee. I'm crossing in front. So let's try it a couple more times. I go step, shuffle side, cross in front. Step, shuffle side, cross in front. Step, shuffle side, cross in front. I'm going to try it on the other side as well. So this time I'm taking my right foot, jumping onto it. Jump to the right foot, shuffle the left foot, shuffle on that diagonal. Jump to that left foot now. So I cross and I go. Jump to the right foot. Shuffle and cross. Jump, shuffle, and cross. So for a minute, we're going to kind of break it down and just work on the jump from one side to the other. So I'm going, jump from one foot, and then I have to jump back to the other foot. And I go jump and a jump. Jump and a jump. If I take out all of the tap moves and I just focus on the jumps, that's all I'm doing. I'm just jumping slightly forward and slightly back. Jump forward, jump back. Jump forward, jump back. So that jump, don't get too mixed up with the jump. It's pretty simple. I just have my jump, shuffle, and jump, cross. Jump, shuffle, jump, cross. Try the other side 2 more times. I go jump, shuffle, jump, cross. Jump, shuffle, jump, cross. Good job, dancers. Again, rewatch this section. If you feel like you need a little bit more practice with those buffaloes, you can go back and watch it as many times as you need, especially the parts where we kind of break it down. Yeah? Okay. Okay, dancers, it is time for us to practice our tap dance for recital. Now, I'm going to do a very, very quick review of everything we know so far, and we're going to add on a little bit more. So we have our formation, our starting formation, our 2 lines, where you have your partner and your little mini diagonals. I've got Annie in the back and Vivian in the front, Avery in the back line, Madeline in the front line, Maeve in the back line, Leah in the front line, Maya in the back line, and Alexandra in the front line. my count five to hit our pose, right? Because we hold with our hands on our hips. One, two, three, four. And then we hit that pop star pose. Left hand stays on your hip. Right hand goes behind your head. And we pop that right knee. Five, six, seven, eight. And then we bring our hands back to our hips and our feet back together for our paradiddles, right? So number five is Annie and Vivian. Number six is Avery and Madeline. Number seven is Maeve and Leah. And Maya and Alexandra are on eight. Yes, so we should know our counts by now, but just a quick review there. We do our four paradiddles, right? Paradiddle two, three, four. Our heel dig rocks to the side with our arms four times. And then our shuffle, ball change, shuffle, step. So that shuffle, ball change, shuffle, step together. Other side, shuffle, ball change, shuffle, step together. Our two stomp, stomp, spank backs. Stomp, stomp, spank back, spank back. Stomp, stomp, spank back, spank back. And our paddle turn, step on the left foot. Paddle the right foot to turn that boat, paddle that boat in a circle till we get back to the front. Then I have my toe heel crisscross to the right three times. So I go open one and cross two, open three, step together, two cramp rolls, right foot first, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. And I take it back to the left, open and across, and open together, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. Now, after that, we have our flap heels, our eight flap heels. That is what we added last time. For now, we're not going to worry about where we go next, where our next actual spot in the formations are. But you're just going to take eight flap heels to somewhere else in the room, to a new spot. Yes? So I take my flap heel, right? Kick that balloon, pop the balloon, and put that heel down. Flap heel, flap heel. Eight times somewhere else in the room. Yes? Now, after that, this is what we're adding on today. We have, we're going to be making a V formation. So again, like I said, don't worry about finding your spot. I'm not going to bother giving you guys your formations just yet, but we are going to be making a V formation. It's going to be the opposite way of how it is for our ballet dance, where the peak of our V is towards the back of the stage and the open part is towards the front. In this one, it's going to be reversed. But our spots are going to be different, so you won't necessarily be in the same spots. So I have the peak at the front and it's open at the back, and we are going to go two at a time from the front to the back. Two at a time, we're making our X heel up downs. So when I do those, balance on my heel, up up and down down, up up down down. So we're just doing one of them, but you're going with a partner, and here are our partners. So when I say ones, that's going to be Madeline and Leah together. So you guys are on one. And when I say two, that's going to be Avery and Maeve together. You guys are two. When I say three, that's Vivian and Alexandra. And when I say four, that's Annie and Maya. So again, Madeline and Leah, one. Avery and Maeve, two. Vivian and Alexandra, three. And Annie and Maya, four. Yes, so we have our one, two, three, four. When I run the dance for you guys, I'm going to be doing four X's right in a row. One, two, three, and four. Just go on whichever one is yours. One, two, three, or four. Do not do all four of them. After our X's, we are doing our chorus part again, but just in these new spots. So that chorus part is our shuffle ball change, shuffle step, stomp, stomp, spank back, spank backs, and our paddle turns around. So I go again, shuffle ball change, shuffle step, shuffle ball change, shuffle step, stomp, stomp, spank back, spank back, stomp, stomp, spank back, spank back, and paddle turn around yourself. So that is our chorus part. We do it at the beginning. We also do it again here. After our X's, one, two, three, or four. All right, let's get ready to practice that dance with our music. Make sure you know which counts you're on. Hands on hips, two, three, four, hit, five, six, shuffle ball, chain shuffle step. Tokyo crisscross. Together. Up, up, down, down. Up, up, down, down. Tokyo crisscross. And flap heels, flap heel. And our X is one. Shuffle step. Stomp, stomp. Paddle turn. Good job. You're getting real close to the end of this dance. Okay, dancers, that is all for our week three class. We are going to have our spring break week next. And then after that, we'll be back with our week four class.